jobs, they just take leave week or so and come here or any other place and attend the workshop and go back to the country. And so the opportunity cost, which technically people say, opportunity cost is not much.
Yes.
And the social and individual cost, your private cost, it's much, much less. And the fees it is charging is much less as compared to the other formal institutions of the country in the public sector.
Yeah, yeah, of course.
So, number one, access, as you earlier said, it is providing access to farthest corners of the country.
Yes.
Number one. Number two, it is trying to support them to improve the quality. Yes, the quality aspect, like any other part of the country, not specifically with this distance education, quality is an issue. Quality of education is an issue in all the education institutions. So I think in terms of quality, at least the university is endeavoring to improve the quality like any other institution. It's not specific to this institution, and we are trying to provide more student support services to reduce their complaints, reduce their problems. But still, there is always place for improvement.
Yes.
And I think we have a lot of things which we can improve and improve the quality. Quality is related to the number of to the books, instructional material, the media material, the tutors, the examination system. Wherever we feel the weakness, it has to be improved.
Right.
So mainly in terms of student, I would say the quality of our instructional material still needs to be improved. And the tutorial system needs to be improved. There are problems, or no, the student outcome. But at the same time, I know the examples where the students come to other teacher tutorial because they feel that they are getting better with this attendance.
Yeah.
On the, as compared to some other teacher where the student don't go. They might be feeling that we don't get from that teacher much about our studies. But still it needs to be improved. Materials also, and that the examination system, like our ills in our society.
Right. That is reflecting in
that
every institution.
Every institution. So it is, I am saying that these weaknesses are with us, but they are the same with other institutions. Roots are somewhere else. So we need to improve, definitely, yes, we need to improve the quality. But in terms of quantity, still there are lakhs of people, millions of people who cannot access.
Right.
For various reasons. One of the reasons could be they cannot pay the fee. And perhaps one of the steps that recently has been taken as student support fund, perhaps this is the name.
Yes,
I think it is also one of the ways to bring in, to motivate the people who cannot pay the fee. Although the fees are relatively less, but still they cannot pay.
Yes. People who are living beneath the poverty line,
level,
they cannot even afford this fee structure of the university.
This is also.
Dr. Sir, would you like to say something about that in the initial periods, as we know, we were writing our courses and as instructional material, you were saying, and then there were a blend of study centers and workshops, a blend of sort of formal system things. What do you feel about that? That was necessary for improvement, or to some extent we are deviating to our prime system? What do you feel?
I feel that at the initial stages, everybody praises himself. But the fact remains that the people at that time, early years, maybe 70s, 80s, they had to really contribute to the system,
right,
to the material, to the support services as far as possible. So there was a time, initial stages, the teachers used to write the units by hand.
Yes.
Write them, preparing stencils, getting copies, stapling themselves, writing the assignments, and then helping to mail them. So that was the stage, but now we don't have, we don't need it. We have the computers. But at that time, many of our colleagues used to write the units and then prepare stencils, have them copies, prepare copies, and then books and send to the students. That was very initial stage. Like foundation course was one of them.
Right.
Although that material was cyclostyled, although guest effects were available, it was used, used where needed. Since we were at the learning stage, especially, learning is always there, but that was very, very beginning.
Right.
So, in addition to the courses arranged by the specialists, by the organization like PTV, radio, UNESCO, we were also sent abroad for training in writing of material. At the initial stage in 70s, 78, 76, etc., we had four types of workshops for the teachers, for
right.
the academics. Number one, writing instructional material for distance education, assessment techniques in distance education, radio writing, broadcast, not broadcast material for the system. All these things, they were her workshops, and we had the books, and our consultants were mainly from UK Open University. And then we used to have, and still there are certain courses which are related to distance education. So at that time, since we were learning and we were trying to implement the best practices available there, I would give you an example of coasting. We still have the coasting.
Yes.
And they are functioning. But since we didn't have much to offer, we had to, although it took a lot of time, I know, but at the same time, it was a real coasting work. Some of the courses that I was involved in, we used to have the identification of the authors as you do now.
Yeah.
And they were writing the units, and then we had the real coasting meetings. All the four, five, six people, in addition some other experts who were very helpful and was motivated to help the development of the course. Although he was not a writer,
right.
but he had the interest.
Sir, do you feel nostalgic about Open University?
No doubt. As I mentioned earlier, joined very early, at very early stage, and when I look at the size and contribution, the services of the university, and the number of students, the number of courses, level of courses, I really feel very, very proud about the institution that I was a part of. And I pray that it should continue to work as it is and it should progress further to make it one of the best and one of the biggest universities in the world in the system of distance education.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you
Thank
for
you
coming,
sir.
Most welcome. Salaam.